imagination. It creates a direction in your life. If you do not control your imagination, if you never develop your imagination, you will always doing the same things as everybody else. You will base all your choices based on your five senses, what you see, hear, smell, taste and touch, what you have already done and what you see other people doing. So you will always recreate things someone else already done. You take actions based on what feels good if you do not control your imagination. If you do not have an image in your mind of the future, you will always take action what feels good in a moment, but never thinking about the long-term results of something. You will always gravitate towards people and things that give you pleasure in the short moment, but never thinking about the next few years, because the outside controls what you think, because you do not control your own imagination. So you do not control how you think your life is supposed to be. You just are the average between everybody else. But when you control this image in your mind, it's the steering wheel. Because when you have this image in your mind and you come the next few years, you start to connect dots in your mind that will get you to that image in your mind. You will have to keep it to see paths and ways towards that thing in your mind. And this will not happen in a day, this will not happen in a week, but in the next few years, if you keep that image in your mind, you will send out that vibration and you will attract opportunities. And you will connect dots, you will see, hey, this is a way to get there, this is a way to get there, this is a way to get there. And when you know a lot of ways and you put them together, you can create for yourself the best possible actions to get there. This can only be done when you create your own image in your mind, how you think your future is supposed to be. When you let the outside control your mind, what happens with a lot of people, they can use commercials or that kind of stuff. They put an image in your mind and you will take unconscious action on that image in your mind. But you can take unconscious action based on an image you created yourself. So you will take daily actions toward a dream you have created yourself, and that's how your human body is supposed to work. Not to take actions on what the environment created in your mind, but what you yourself created in your mind. Because we have never learned to use our imagination in school, the system can use your mind. Your imagination is the most important thing you can develop. Because when you start to visualize your own life, your goal, your dream, you start to bring it closer to you. Because everything first happens in the mind before it happens in the outside world. So when you have visualized this dream of yours daily, and you walk through life in just your daily habitual life, you start to notice different things. Things pop up more in your five senses because you have connected those dots. So if you have connected the dots to get to a certain goal, you will start to see certain things better. And because you see those things better, you will take action on them. And that's only because you have connected those dots first with your imagination. You will attract those things too, because you send out that vibration. Because you have connected the dots that way, you vibrate at a different frequency. And that frequency starts to attract that opportunities. The only way to get somewhere is with daily actions, to become better at it. By daily using this, you start to become a different person. Because you need to become a different person to make this image in your mind a realization. If you never, the next few years, use your imagination and just live your life how you are living it right now, you'll always be running in the same circle. because you do not use your imagination, so you do not have a direction in life. So the environment always controls your direction. But when you start to use your own mind in the way you want to go to, you maybe not break out right away, but you start to notice ways to break out. This whole system is created so we cannot use our own mind the right way. We cannot use our body in a way that we can make something of value for this world. Because we're all constantly, we have to learn from the outside in, and we never can use our mind the right way to create something unique of value to make this organism we all live in better. When we live in such a state with not using imagination and just consume and work and consume, we're stuck in our animal behavior. We're not gonna get happy that way. Only when we start to vibrate at our own vibration, we have to create our own vibration to use our mind the right way, to use our vibration to create something in reality. Because only by creating our own unique vibration, we can think in our own unique way. And by only thinking in our own unique way, we can take our own unique actions. In the system we are stuck in that lets us not vibrate on our own unique way, we cannot think in our own unique way. We think the same as everybody else. That's why we are doing the same things as everybody else. But when you are alone and you start to meditate more, and you start to vibrate at your own frequency, you start to be able to use this imagination more. Because when you use this imagination, you make contact with a dimension where it's possible. You can make a connection with your imagination, with the dimension, because there are all different dimensions. You can watch a video on that too. And only by making contact with that dimension, you can move towards that dimension in a logical way. But you have to connect the dots first, follow your intuition, follow the things that you attract that pop up, and slowly, over the next few years, you make that image in your mind a reality. But it all starts in the mind. It all starts in here. If you do not control it in here, you will always take the actions based on what everybody else is doing. So you have to start to believe more in your inside world than you have to be in your outside world. Because we're so stuck in our five senses and live in this fast speed of living, we do not believe in our own mind. We do not believe in ourselves. Because we have never had the chance to make something in our mind a reality. Only when you make it habitual to make things from your mind a reality, you can start to do it with bigger things. We do not believe we can make a reality of our imagination. But that's how everything is created. That is how everything is created. People will not go to the gym for a long period of time if they do not control the image of their mind, an image of themselves in their mind, how they want to be. People will not start to do a certain job or do a certain thing before they have the image in their mind how they think it is supposed to be, or how they think they will feel or they will be. That is why people gravitate towards those short things and that everybody is doing, because they can imagine themselves doing that and it's easy. And the dimension is not far away, so they know all the conscious actions to get to that dimension. But you can only connect the dots backwards. So if you have a big dream, you have to follow your intuition. And when you have achieved that big dream of your imagination, you can connect the dots backwards and it goes automatic because you know how to do it. But you can only do that by first creating your imagination of the dimension you want to go to. Follow your intuition, follow your feelings. Use your thoughts to get you closer to your dimension until it's a reality. But don't let the environment control your vibration and your thinking. Because you will always be pulled back in the same way of thinking as everybody else. And no one is using his imagination. It thinks it's useless. But it's very important. So train your imagination, meditate, follow the heart. Mine's just still. Thanks for watching.